In this segment, I will show you how to solve elliptic partial differential equations numerically. If you want to get more information on elliptic partial differential equations, just go to the website, click on keyword, and click on elliptic partial differential equations. So let's go and review what we talked about, how we can look at second order linear partial differential equations. So the differential equation which is shown to you is a second order linear partial differential equation with two independent variables. So this particular partial differential equation has two independent variables x and y, and it has one dependent variable u. And we can recall the criteria for this equation to be elliptic: b squared minus 4ac has to be less than 0. So if we take a typical example of a Laplacian equation here, which is given by this particular second order linear partial differential equation, in this case we have a equal to 1, b is 0 because there is no term of del 2t, del x, del y, and c is equal to 1. That gives us b squared minus 4ac is 0 minus 4 times 1 times 1, gives us minus 4, and since this number is less than 0, we can classify this equation as elliptic. So let's go and look at a physical example of an elliptic partial differential equation. So here we have a plate, and it's of length L, width W. It is maintained at four different temperatures on the four different edges of this rectangle. And the equation which governs this temperature is given by this Laplacian equation here. So the temperature of inside the plate at steady state, given as a function of x and y, will be determined by solving this particular second order linear partial differential equation. Now let's go and see that how we can do that numerically. If you take this particular rectangle which we have right here, and what we're going to do is we're going to break the x-axis length, or the length of this particular plate, into m segments, which makes the length of each of those segments to be L divided by m. We do the same thing, we break up the width of this rectangle into n equal segments, which gives us delta y is equal to w by n. So basically what we have is a grid, a rectangular grid, which is of which this particular rectangular plate is made of. And if we look at what happens at this particular point x comma y, the original second order linear partial differential equation which we have governs the temperature at that particular point. Now in order to be able to solve it numerically, what we're going to do is we're going to take the second derivative of temperature with respect to x, and what we're going to do is that we're going to write it in the central divide difference formula for it. You can derive the central divide difference formula for the second derivative of x, of second derivative of temperature with respect to x, by using Taylor series of two variables. Similarly, you'll find out the second derivative of temperature with respect to y is given by a similar central divide difference formula as shown here. And as you can see here, since we are taking only the partial derivative to x, only the x value changes. Since we're taking the partial derivative only with respect to y, only the y value changes. But one of the things which you got to understand is that what are these points? What is this point? What is this point? And what is this point? So if you're finding the second derivative of temperature with respect to x, you are using the value of the function of the temperature at this point, the value of the temperature at this point, and the value of the temperature at this point to be able to find out what the approximation for the second derivative with respect to x is. In order to find out the approximation to the second derivative of temperature with respect to y, you're using the value of the temperature at this point, the value of the temperature at this point, and the value of the temperature at that particular point. Now, let's go and write these down, these approximations for particular nodes. So since this is a node which is at a location x comma y, what we're going to do is now we're going to name the nodes. We're going to number the nodes. We're going to say, hey, this is node I, and that's node I in the x-axis and node j in the y-axis. And the surrounding nodes which we have along the x-axis will be I plus 1 comma j, and on the left would be I minus 1 comma j. The node which is above the current node is I comma j plus 1, and the node below is I comma j minus 1. So we're basically replacing the actual coordinates of x and y by node numbers. That's all we are trying to do. So we are saying that the second derivative of temperature with respect to x, if we want to write the second derivative of temperature with respect to x at I comma jth node, rather than saying that hey, it is at one of the terms is t at x plus delta x comma y, we'll say that hey, it is the value of the temperature at I plus 1 comma j, which in fact is the coordinates of this particular point here are x plus delta x comma comma y. So nothing has changed, it's just that we're numbering the nodes now. So similarly, this will be the I jth node, this will be the I minus 1 comma jth node, and so we're rewriting our formula for in terms of the node numbers. Similarly, it happens for the second partial derivative, which is with respect to y. We again converting the locations of the coordinates here into node numbers. That's what we are doing here in this formula here. So now what we have is the second derivative of temperature to x at the i comma jth node. We have the second derivative of temperature to y at I comma jth node, and we're going to substitute this back into the original second order linear partial differential equation to write down the equation just in terms of the temperatures at particular nodes. So this is our original second order linear partial differential equation. We approximated this by this at the I comma jth node. We approximated this at the same I comma jth node by this. So we add the two. Now, rather than having partial derivatives, we are writing it in terms of the temperatures at particular points and the length and the widths of the grid, which are delta x and delta y. If for purposes of keeping things simple, we choose delta x equal to delta y, we can multiply both sides by delta x square, where we'll get an equation without the use of the length and the width of the grid, and we'll get it as follows. So what you are seeing here is that you have discretized the elliptic partial differential equation. You have written the partial differential equation at node I comma j, and you have introduced four new unknowns in there, because now you have temperatures at this node, and this node, and this node included. So what we have to figure out is that how can we write more equations so that we can find out the temperatures at each and every node which is in that in at those grid points or the nodal points. How can we find the temperature of those? But the main issue which we have solved here is to see that how we have discretized our second order linear partial differential equation and find some ways of solving them. There are three different ways by which you can solve this discretized elliptic partial differential equation. One is called the direct method, and the one is called the Gauss-Seidel method, and the third one is called the Lieberman method. And we'll be discussing each of these methods in three separate audiovisual lectures. So that depending on whether you want to learn all three methods or just one method, you'll be able to do so. And that's the end of this segment.